Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org with a new Hibernate tip. This time I will show you how to call a PostgreSQL function. As I explained in my video about using a PostgreSQL database with Hibernate, there are multiple options to call a PostgreSQL function. If it's one of SQL's or PostgreSQL standard functions that are supported by Hibernate's PostgreSQL dialect, you can simply call it in a JPQL query. You can see such a query here on the slide. It gets more complicated if it's a custom function or any other function that's not supported by Hibernate's PostgreSQL dialect. You then need to either create your own Hibernate dialect or use JPA's function. It was introduced in JPA 2.1 and gives you a generic way to define a function call. Let's get into the IDE and take a closer look at it. Here you can see a query that uses the JPQL function. You just need to provide the name of the database function as the first parameter, followed by the parameters you want to provide to your function call. Here you can see the generated SQL statement. Hibernate used the parameters provided to the JPQL function to generate a function call within the SQL statement. And you can also call all PostgreSQL functions as a stored procedure. You therefore create a named stored procedure query and define the name you will use to reference this query, the name of the stored procedure, and all parameters. You can then instantiate the named stored procedure query by providing its name to the create named stored procedure query method of your entity manager. This method returns a stored procedure query interface, which you can then use to set the values of the input parameters and to execute the query. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate, a printable PDF version of this Hibernate tip, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip, and if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!